All right, so now we're going to see what we actually do with diodes in circuits. The first circuit we want to look at is called a halfway rectifier. All right, and that's a circuit shown just the way it's shown here, where we have a diode here and a resistor here. Since the diode only allows current in one direction, only the positive half of the voltage will show up, just as we saw in a previous slide. Okay. And so here we have the situation that I drew before. Here's the positive voltage. We get nothing when the oscillating voltage goes the other way. So basically, what comes out is a lumpy looking function that looks like this. There's a little bit of voltage, as it says here, that's required to turn the diode on. Okay, so why would we do this? If we filter this by adding a capacitor, you see we're always going to have current flowing in this direction, which is always going to give us a positive voltage across there. That positive voltage will charge up this capacitor. And this is actually a low pass filter. And if we add this capacitor in, it begins to charge up and eventually produces something that's DC-like. It isn't really quite DC because it has something called a ripple on top of the DC value. A full-wave rectifier looks like this. If we have current flowing this way, it would flow through here, cross the load, back like this, through there. If the current is flowing in the other direction, it would flow through the load in exactly the same direction, but go through the diodes in the opposite direction. Here is the way a full-wave rectifier looks in PSPICE, and so it's a little easier to see what's going on here. So we have the current going this way, the current passes through there and down here. If the current is going this way, it would pass through here and through there and up there. And you see it's always passing through the load in exactly the same direction. Therefore, the voltage would always be plus minus for this sort of a configuration. And what we end up with is something that looks like this, where we get the positive voltages and always positive voltages. Again, with the 1.4 volts lost, because we have to turn two diodes on in order to make this happen. And again, if we add a little bit of capacitance across there, we get something that charges up and kind of holds the charge on the average. And we end up with something that looks sort of like DC with a little bit of ripple on top of it. If we use enough filtering, a big enough capacitor, this smooths out quite nicely. So if a time-varying voltage is only positive or only negative all the time, then it will have a DC offset, even if the original voltage has no offset. If we rectify a sinusoidal signal and then filter out the remaining time-varying signal, we'll be able to obtain a DC voltage from an AC source. So that's the point. Most of the circuits that we deal with require DC values. We've seen that for all of the chips. They require 9 volts or 15 volts DC, something like that. But when you go to get the power from the wall, it comes out as 110 volts. And so we have to turn it into, somehow or other, turn it into a constant DC voltage. Second thing that we can do with diodes, which actually looks a little bit odd, is that if we put two diodes like this and then say we had the load out here somewhere, whenever the voltage here would exceed 0.7 volts, this diode would turn on and it would short things out that way. When it exceeds minus 0.7 volts, this diode would turn on and it would short things out that way. So we actually can keep voltages below 0.7 volts by putting these across the load. This is actually one of the ways that we protect the mobile studio board from getting trashed by hooking the wrong things up to it, by having some protection circuitry like the diodes across the inputs. It's not 0.7 volts, but you can do this with combinations of diodes and come up with bigger voltages. All right, and this just shows an example of voltage limitation. Here's the voltage being kept. No matter what the voltage is, positive or negative, the voltage never exceeds 0.7 volts or minus 0.7 volts, and this keeps us from destroying equipment. And we'll continue in a minute.